So far, 10 teams have qualified for their chance to design a spaceship for Star Citizen. And now, the judges must make their final selections, and the race for the wild card is on. Welcome to the Next Great Starship. Hi, I'm Sandy Gardner, and welcome to the third episode of the Next Great Starship. Let's get this show started. I can't do this alone. I need the judges. So, Mark, come on up.
Bam.
All right, Sean. Chris.
Which one?
Chris's.
Three stooges over there.
All right, Mark Skelton, Sean Tracy, Chris Roberts, Chris Smith, and Chris Olivier. For those of you who are new viewers to the Next Great Starship, let's have the judges tell you what they do on Star Citizen. Mark Skelton.
Art director, fashion guru.
I work for Crytek, CryEng Evangelist, making sure the engine does what Chris Roberts needs it to do.
Chris Roberts, project director and chief creative on the project.
Chris Smith, I'm the lead vehicle modeler.
And I'm Chris Livia, chief visual officer for Star Citizen.
So they're going to make their final five selection today. What do you guys think of the competition so far?
We've had two episodes of pretty amazing stuff that, you know, pretty much all of it we liked. We had a few criticisms, but the level of competition's really high, and I would expect this episode to be the same. And then once we've got it done, I'm looking forward to seeing the ships get made.
And the only reason we have criticisms is because we have to have criticisms to, like, move right. Yeah, other really people on.
We're nice guys most of the time.
We try.
Honestly, with like any of these teams where we're at right now, with the level that they're at, I mean, with the little art direction on our part, I think we could
A little bit of you mean? Is that what
little
you mean?
A little bit of Mark.
A little bit of gold shirt.
Well, I know if you guys don't hire some of these guys, I will. So,
no, I mean, I'm ready to like hire some of them and replace a few of the guys we have.
Oh. Damn.
For competition entry, teams were asked to design a gun.
You guys know the drill. We're going to look at eight teams. Only five will go through. Three go into the wild card race. Should we get this started?
Let's do it.
All right. Let's go.
Good day, ladies and gents of the Starship Council. We are Team Arkham. May I introduce to you my esteemed colleague, Matt Kent, team lead responsible for 3D modeling, unwrapping, and the CryEngine integration.
And may I introduce to you, Lewis Linehan, texture and concept artist extraordinaire.
And if you haven't guessed it by now, we are Great British.
Currently residing in the great city of London.
So where better to design the next great starship?
Mark Skelton, what did you think?
The gun itself, the design, I think it's a little Klingon to me. There's a lot of like big, bulky shapes to it. They're all stacked kind of on top of each other.
A lot of angles going in a different direction.
Yeah, and it kind of, it doesn't flow very well, the gun, from beginning to end. The silhouette is too chunky for me, and there's too many things stacked.
Totally agree with you on that one. Most of the stuff is all stacked up together. You got a lot of repeating elements all the way through it. The in-engine stuff is actually really nice, though. It was good that they got it right in. The materials look great. The textures look okay.
That's probably the best in-the-engine integration of all the ones we saw.
Impressive.
Because they hooked it up into the firing range that we'd set up in the hangar. And I kind of like the multi-barrel aspect where they would all recoil separately, so that was cool. I sort of felt like the shapes, for me, it was all a bit sort of... right angle, square. I mean, I don't feel like the gun itself had as much detail as I would have liked to see in parts of it.
Great implementation. The modeling seems okay, and the textures, I mean, But yeah, it's the design that kind of holds it back, I think.
Yeah, overall it had an interesting sort of style, but it lacked a lot of subtlety. There's too much contrast between the materials, and it's just sort of very harsh to look at. So
yeah. You want to draw your eye to that glow, but you know, if you're going to put it in these strange places, it's just, of course, you're going to look at it and be like, why?
Right, you know, so a lot of times the glow will just like distract you, and it's just overdone.
Yeah, totally, so some purposeful detail, maybe?
It's glowing.
Like the shirt, yeah, exactly, going to dry your
Your eye goes
so subtle to the chest hair. Right.
And that's the other point, too, for as the competition goes on. I mean, the engine really looks a lot better when you put some lights in. That's the thing. It needs the light material interaction.
Difference.
It's going to change the look of the weapon altogether. Even if you don't adjust them, get three lights around the thing, it'll look fantastic. So.
Okay. So good points for being an engine and maybe needs a little bit of love in the design and texturing. All right, let's look at the next one.
Hello, my name is Adam Kirchgesner. And my name is Brian Kirchgesner, and together we make Persimmon Productions located here in Amarillo, Texas. Our Windfire EX design consists of two particle accelerators, as well as a large cooling system, dual magnetic retaining arms, and dual perpendicular rotating barrels.
The Chris couch. Chris Olivia, what'd you think?
I like the start of the presentation to where they're doing the turntable in an X-ray mode, you know, to really see like all the geometry and stuff. But I was a little underwhelmed overall.
I thought it was actually kind of interesting, the design. Definitely unique. I would say, you know, the modeling was fine. The texturing could definitely use some work, and the front barrels probably like could use a little bit more love in the design area.
I mean, I think wasn't the idea that the outside things are just sort of accelerating stuff from inside?
Like, was the animation inside like too rotating?
So, it sort of felt like
something
was... It was
just hard to see, that's all. Like,
it felt like something was like...
They had these particle effects
going
that was all refracted and couldn't read it.
It looks a little bit like a wood chipper.
Yeah. Oh, right.
That's the only thing, you know.
Now that you say that, now I can't
It seemed like the barrels were a little bit just too
the
thin.
Guides. They look like matchsticks.
Right, right.
Like two matchsticks on each side.
Yeah, I think the idea is they're not actually...
Yeah, they're not
they're firing. They're just like a magnet that's accelerating something inside.
And that was what I... The one thing that I would comment about, I like the uniqueness of it. It's pretty cool. They kind of thought about it a little bit differently, and I like the acceleration aspect of it. But to me, it maybe feels more like a tractor beam or something. It doesn't feel like a badass weapon, right? It doesn't feel like... You don't really... Like, the business end of it isn't intimidating at all.
The in-engine stuff was okay. I mean, they could have spent maybe another few, like an hour maybe, just, you know, putting some textures down so it's not all
maybe
completely placeholder. Sorry?
Maybe some lights.
Maybe a few lights. It would look a lot better. Yeah, definitely. Definitely stands out in the competition in terms of its uniqueness, I would say.
Let's roll the next one.
Hey, everyone. This is Team Four Horsemen. Four Horsemen is Tobias, myself, and David. Tobias is our concept artist. He lives in Germany. I myself am a 3D artist and texture artist, and I live in the Netherlands. David is our general artist who lives in Canada.
Sure. There was no in-engine implementation, so, you know, a little bit. I would have liked to see that.
Strike.
Strike. That would have been nice to see, absolutely, because actually the texture work is phenomenal. The materials looked great in the render that they had. I like the shape of the weapon. It's really bulky. It looks like it's a very strong sort of weapon, but it does also look like something you would hold on to rather than something getting mounted on a ship.
So if you're going to try and get that into engine, how long do you think it would take you?
Take me?
Yeah.
5 minutes.
5 minutes.
All right.
Just, no way.
No, it'd probably take about an hour. So it really depends. Really depends on the geometry and how well the textures were laid out.
For some reason, this gun, I love it. It's cool. I like the bigness of it. And I like the concept. The concept was amazing.
Concept,
I mean, great.
Yeah, blew me away.
Oh, yeah. The concept. Nice color. Nice variation throughout the gun. For some reason, I don't know why, but it reminds me of steampunk. For some reason, there's like a steampunk element. It doesn't look far future. It looks like it could conceivably happen today. You could have a gun like that. Mm. I think you're right, the materials, I think, probably could have been broke up better. If they break up the materials, I think that gun, like, goes up three notches for me.
Yeah, I mean, I thought the concept was really well done.
Yeah.
And I wish they kind of would have implemented that in the model a little bit better. It was modeled fine, but the materials, they kind of came off as like a weird gold. It looked very heavy and powerful.
It seemed to have lost something from the concept almost looked more realistic than when it was modeled. And I think the materials and the concept, it was like, wow, that's like a really interesting use of the different metals and stuff. And it just sort of lost that. And I think overall, it didn't have much of an alien influence at all. Disagree with you a little bit in that I don't think you can hold something like that. That I think it would
Right, but it's got these big racks on the top where it's like.
Right. I mean, I could probably hold it, but
walk them around.
I do agree with Chris that there's no sort of sense of an alien influence or design. It feels very sort of straight up sort of badass space marine to me, and so I would kind of knock it down a little bit for that, but I do think the modeling and the concept execution was really good. And, you know, it would have been interesting to see how they thought that gun would deploy, how it would fire, what the recoil would be, because, you know, I know that wasn't necessary for everyone, that wasn't required, but it definitely helps tell the story of the gun, right?
Sure. So sell it.
It makes it feel real, right? Because, well, like when it animates and moves, it sort of, it gives you a sense of the weight and the power of something.
So a big part of like this competition is selling it through animation and how it moves and lighting, right?
Yeah.
All you judges seem to like the concept art, design, maybe a little more love in a couple of areas. Questionable as it's not in game. Although it only takes 5 minutes, according to Sean Tracy.
Apparently.
Oh, for Sean Tracy. Right. But that's not a normal person.
Or Dan Tracy, my brother.
Yeah. So we'll just have to see on that one. Let's roll the next one.
Hi. My name is Henry Pashko. I am a concept and environment designer for GAME.
Hello, my name is Daniel Winograd, and I'm working with Stranek and Kajasi on the Next Great Starship project. I am 21 years old, and I live in Harwood, New Jersey.
Hi, my name is Alexander Aberly. I come from Battleground, Washington. I've brought my skills in computer animation and film production to bear on this product, and what we have created has been phenomenal.
Daniel is a CryEngine god.
I saw that.
Yeah, I think Mr. Sean's going to have something to say about that.
Well,
we'll see.
The owners of Crytek would have something to say about that. I would say.
The problem with this gun for me is A, it looks like Flash Gordon, like from like the 1960s or something. There's no real breakup, there's no details. The way that the barrel has those notches in them all the way down, I mean, that again, that's frequency, like we had talked about before. If you have something high frequency like that, your eye immediately goes straight to it, and it just blows the design.
When you have like high frequency things like that, you got to be careful with lighting and texturing and stuff, because that's where it'll ruin it. But I mean, you can do that if it's executed well.
So I thought, actually, the gun, design-wise, had a lot of promise. I liked a lot of elements about it, but I think the materials and the texturing were lacking quite a bit. It was all this sort of consistent gloss, and there was not a lot of work in the little details, maybe making it a little bit beat up and looking. I think that could have helped the gun a lot. I mean, he had this sort of, you know, chrome texture, and it's sort of very basic looking to me.
It's very sort of elementary that when you just pop a chrome
Yeah, I mean, it felt like it was, you were just sort of putting a default material and texture on
it. And I think a lot of these things, in general, it's like, yes, they're brand new right out of the manufacture, but you need to get in there and break up the materials with a little bit more occlusion in the crevices and even some like scratches and dirt.
Subtle amount. Yeah.
Just a subtle amount.
Give it some character. That's the thing. Give it some identity. Like, it's not an iPhone.
Otherwise, it just goes cartoony.
You know, the in-engine stuff, that was actually pretty cool, what they managed to do there. You know, they got the gun firing up at the ship.
Maybe he's a minor cry-engine deity.
Yeah. Maybe, So he seemed to be able to implement it pretty well. Sub-deity. And I bet you it takes him 5 minutes.
So a demigod, perhaps.
Demigod.
Yeah, crashing demigod.
Yeah, right.
He just, we've knocked him down
in engine.
I think it had a nice mix of alien and human.
I mean, I actually
like the shapes.
I actually didn't mind the shape and design. I didn't have the same frequency issue that Mark did. Mm-hmm. So it was more about the materials, the texturing, and then just some of the details of like how it would fire and where it was coming from. It could have been, like Chris says, it could have been good and interesting, but it's sort of like it was halfway done.
All right, let's see who's next.
Hi, my name is Simon Ma. I am a designer and modeler at Sakura Sun Corporation in charge of the weapon technology for particle cannons.
Hey, I'm Gage Hallman. I handle rigging and animation for this project.
Hi, I'm Dan Kovetsky, modeler monkey number 2. I handle extra modeling on this assignment.
Can I go first on this one?
I saw a lot of nods.
I freaking love this one. This one's awesome. I mean, because all the presentation was in engine, because that's where it matters. That's where the player is going to see it. Like, all this stuff outside of the engine doesn't matter until it's there. The animation's fantastic. The particle effect that they did in engine is also very cool. They had this really nice ramp up of color. So it went, you know, from like a dark blue all the way to the orange where it was firing away. The animation of the overheat, that's also very nice with little effects coming off that. Yeah, all the details were taken into account here. Very, very impressive.
I thought the details in the animation of the weapon was really good. Implementation in engine was really good. And I like the design of the weapon. I would critique sort of the texturing because it was kind of low res.
That's
when you got up there.
They got way too close to it.
They could up-res that and it wouldn't have had that. They were trying to make it sort of a bit sort of weathered and used, but it was just too low res.
Chris, what are you thinking?
Overall, I love this gun. It's a great design, and I do like the coloration of it and everything, and the texturing was good, but the low res thing, that close up, the pits were too deep. Yeah. And it made it look porous almost and a little like weak. And I think that kind of, you know, the pits being so deep, it makes it look and seem more low res than it might be the texture.
They could have just pulled the camera back a foot. I like it when there's a lot of sort of layers and depth to the engineering of it. And it felt I always like when things feel cohesive and like it's part of one
cooling
machine.
Cooling thing. Yeah.
So I know, I agree with everybody. It was very impressive.
Well, I think it's a great design. It's very anime-ish, which is cool. I mean,
kinda
I like that.
Though.
I like that because it's like, it introduces alien elements, which I, you know, it feels like
it's Sakura Sun, right? So it's a sort of kind of Japanese-ish company.
Right.
So slightly anime feel would feel
fits
right.
Nicely.
I was like very impressed by their commitment to also keeping in shape while they're in front of a keyboard.
Yeah,
so we should actually have some dumbbells here while we're sitting.
For me, so far, this is the best gun today.
These are the best guns today.
Look at that.
No,
you got programmer guns, man.
Programmer guns.
Not those small guns.
Yeah, we got a couple of pop guns over there.
I'll touch
Let's roll the next one.
Hi, my name is Jan Mischke. I'm living in Yokohama in Japan. One of my hobbies, computer games and computer graphics. I was really eager to join this contest for Star Citizen because it's a big motivation to develop your skills. So have a look.
I simulated two different firing modes for this cannon, the sequential firing mode and the parallel fire.
Quite a bit of nodding over here.
Yeah, well, no, that's pretty impressive. For me, it reads as a gun that I could believe that would be on the ships. I thought it was modeled well, I thought it was textured well. I probably could have seen a bit, we didn't really see any animation in terms of like the gun recoiling or anything like that. I mean, I liked the particle effects. I thought that was good. Thought it looked good in the engine. So, generally, I thought that was a really nice entry and impressive that it was just one person doing it.
Had a little bit of a Star Wars feel to it the paint job.
That's probably why I liked it.
Rebel Alliance.
Yeah, just the Rebel Alliance color scheme there.
But yeah, it was good design. I agree with you. Maybe you could use some more animations. The texturing was good. And I did like the pink scheme overall and everything. It did seem a little bit maybe even all across, but I think actually the gun would fit well with a lot of our ships.
Mm-hmm. I thought it was a very elegant design. It wasn't overly complicated. And even though the silhouette was somewhat basic, it had a nice clean feel to it. It had just, I think, the right amount of detail. So I was really impressed.
Yeah, it feels like this could be like a robot arm, which is cool. Robotech. I like that. It's got a very smooth design to it. Like Chris was mentioning, the silhouette. I mean, there's not a whole lot of things like sticking out of it. It's a very stylish, smooth gun. It's more like a, you know, it's less like a tank, more like a Ferrari.
It's a simple silhouette, sure, but what's cool about it is that the texturing, the normal maps, everything really goes with the flow of the model anyway. So there's a lot of stuff for your eye to dance on.
In engine comments?
The particle effects were really cool, actually. Those are not super easy to do, so that was pretty impressive. When he's showing it in engine, it would be nice to have some context to the size. That's the only thing, because that thing could be as big of a, you know, as a Star Destroyer, or it could be a really tiny little thing. So having something else in the scene would really, really help. But yeah, you know, it's a small comment.
I think the particle effects sort of help sell the alien hybrid feel to it, because as just by itself, it's like very human.
It's cool right. Energy,
yeah.
Sort of.
So. Yeah, and I just really like that sort of, whatever it was, the second one where it was the
like a tail coming in.
Yeah. Well, yeah, it was sort of, I don't know, kind of
tendrily.
Like, tendrily.
Yeah. Yeah. So how would that sound?
If you were energy to sound tendril.
So I'm not making the sound effects in the game.
Judges are impressed with this one, so let's have a look at the next one.
My name is Brian Cousins. I'm doing special effects art, technical art, programming, and scripting for the team. I am from Cedar City, Utah.
Hello everyone, my name is Sergiu Stojkovic. I'm from Romania, and I'm a 2D and 3D artist of this team.
Hi, I am Eric. I'm one of the artists of the team. I'm from the small town of Lugun in the Philippines.
I love the serrated sort of feel of the thing on the bottom. The lighting and the presentation was like a little bit flat and overlit, so that could have been better.
So I thought the gun was good, actually. There were some parts I liked a little bit less, and I really liked the back end of it, the design and everything. It flowed really well. The front railing thing, I'm not in love with as much
what?
As you are. Reminds me a bit of a swordfish.
Fight!
Swordfish.
But it looked like it had a purpose, you know, uh-huh. It was doing something.
Yeah, the animations are great. The materials could use a little bit more work. I like the carbon fiber kind of thing, but it was maybe a little bit too shiny and a little bit too simplistic looking in places. But overall, I like the design of this gun.
I am not in love with the serrated edge. I think if the frequency was a little different. Maybe at the end of it, instead of having them all exactly the same, maybe the one tooth at the end so maybe was thicker. Yeah, it was like maybe thicker or changed up a little bit. I think that might have, that probably help it.
Right. Yeah. I really liked it. I mean, I do agree with Chris that maybe a bit better lighting when they were showing it off in engine would have helped out. But I liked the design. I sort of felt like the gun itself had a purpose. You could understand where it fired. I mean, I like after it finished firing, it expelled like energy or heat out
that
of the back.
Cool.
So yeah, it's sort of, you know, you really got a sense of like the functionality of the gun. Talk about a team from all around the world. Yeah, I mean, you got one in Romania, one in Philippines, one over
and they all
in
had
Utah.
Cool, lovely facial hair.
And they win on that one too. But yeah, no, it's good. It's impressive. I mean, it's just it's another example of like how much talent we've got entering this competition.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
it's cool.
Gonna be a hard one.
Last video, guys. Let's roll it.
Sweet. Do it.
Hi, my name is Philip Erkinger, and I'm the leader of our small modding team. In the team, I also take the role as the main 3D model.
Hello, my name is Hannah Erkinger. In the team, I have the role of the illustrator, texturing artist, and for concept art.
Hi, my name is Philipp Sackl. I'm still in my 20s. My job in the team is technical designer and also with implementation into the CryEngine.
An elegant design integrates the Xian tech into the main body of the weapon. In front, the ion source as well as the collider are aligned, which together with the Xian matter injector create a perfectly tuned wave to neutralize shields. And finally, this is the integrated and textured weapon in the CryEngine SDK. We hope you enjoyed our presentation and thanks for watching.
This is one of those ones that I was really getting into it, the explaining of the technology and everything, and it was like, oh wow, this is looking cool. And then the final sort of implementation, it was like, oh, it just fell really short for me. So.
I think it works on every level except for the texturing, which is sort of, the material texturing is sort of like, it's all gray.
Right.
But like, if you look at how it's designed and built and how it deploys and how it fires and how it animates, it's like,
that was cool.
That's probably the best design, most, you know, the most thoughts gone into it and all the guns that
you've thought through,
But the texturing side is just kind of gray and it doesn't really have any detail. And then also it doesn't allow those really wonderful parts of the gun that have been designed to stand out.
I mean, if they pulled like a panel off, you could see all the cool things that were
going on.
Yeah,
it's almost kind of like you sort of designed this really wonderful thing and then you'd like, turn the lights off. Yeah,
it was harder to tell. It was animating while it was going. The front barrel animation is really cool, I thought, the way it shuts and opens. But it was, the texturing kind of hindered that because all that black, that same kind of hue. If you got up close to it, it looked like there was some wear and tear and it looked kind of cool. But again, I think some better lighting probably would have helped that out too.
There was no silhouette to it, really. I mean, it doesn't read from afar at all. It looks like a toothpick. Now, the animation is really cool. I like it. But again, if you're going to have something that crazy animated, then it needs to be exaggerated, I think. Like, instead of popping out like an inch like it did, maybe it would be better if it popped out, bigger.
But
you know what I mean?
I don't really agree with you that I think the silhouette's a toothpick. I mean, if you go back and look at it, I actually think if you look at that, it is not a toothpick. Changes. It's actually
it
got some
like
interest and it's
cylinder.
Got some detail.
There's nothing like, there's no, like the previous ones we've seen, there's been like gas canisters or something that has broke the shape from afar.
No, you've definitely got stuff like towards the back and stuff where it absolutely, it's not just a straight cylinder.
I think that's where the failure of showing it off in the engine is just, you're losing it.
But the stuff that they used for it, in my opinion, was too subtle of a change in silhouette for it to read anywhere but right up on it. You know what I mean?
Especially as a weapon on a ship as well.
There was some variations, like minor variations in the silhouette, but again, if it was across the room and I'm looking at it, it would just read as, and the texture didn't help it, it would just read as a big black cylinder.
I think he's responding to the in-engine piece where you see it spinning off at a distance. And you see that, and that's kind of all you see is the barrel start. I mean,
well, it's because it's all spinning, like the front part and the back part. So it's all that one piece is what it looked like. I mean, maybe they, I mean, I don't know. It could be cool looking on a ship and seeing it, you know, seeing the back part rotating fast like that.
Yeah, there was a ton of buildup to this one, and I was really into it, the cross section of it. I'm like, this is going to be freaking awesome. And then it switches to the end engine, which is completely flat, totally ambient lit. There's not a single direct light inside. It's got a little bit of glow on it, which again pulls your eye away from the actual shape of the weapon. The animation was really cool. I like that when it actually deploys out, rotates around. That's really nice. But the effects were a little underwhelming.
Yeah. As a female, I noticed there was a female in the team.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Props to that. We are relatively male dominated at Cloud Imperium, but I guess you've worked with quite a few illustrators, concept designers who are female in the past, Chris.
Oh yeah, absolutely. We're completely gender blind. Just whoever's the best artist. Yep. Yeah. That's all we care.
Okay, judges, so now we have a little surprise for you. We had one team who came in just under the wire. So we had to double check that this video came in basically 1 minute before midnight on New Year's Eve, Los Angeles time. Due to some technical difficulties, we couldn't get it into your selects. So you're going to be seeing this for the first time. If it's in your top five, it goes through. And if it's out, it's out of the competition completely.
Sudden death.
Well, it's very much in the spirit of game development, 1 minute before deadline.
Yeah,
let's roll the video.
All right.
Allora, vai. Ciao, sono Alex. Questo è più o meno il posto dove vivo. Diciamo che è una località in mezzo alle montagne, in Italia. Per la precisione, la Val di Susa, in provincia di Torino, in Piemonte. Il mio ruolo nel gruppo è il 3D artist, tutto quello che riguarda grafica 3D, effetti speciali. Vorrei dare veramente un contributo a tutto questo grande progetto. Quindi ecco perché io ho voluto iniziare questa cosa.
Ciao, sono Michele Schillaci e sono il concept designer dei 3Dingo. Ho 21 anni, vengo da qua, da Bussoleno, provincia di Torino.
Ciao, io sono Enrico Oliva, in arte Mastro 1. Sono un musicista, faccio il sound designer nel gruppo dei 3Dingo.
Dude, I would totally party with those guys.
Yeah.
They definitely awesome. Have the most.
The glasses are amazing.
They have got the most nothing style. But energy.
Yeah.
That was cool.
Nothing like us.
No, nothing like us.
So you liked it, Mark?
I thought that was fun. I thought it was great.
Yeah, it was a great video.
I liked their attitude. I liked, I actually thought it was quite nice that was one of the few times that one of the contestants took some of the concept art that we've supplied. And even though we're developing what the genre's going to look like, they were looking at it and sort of trying to meld it into their shape.
That was great.
So I thought the design looked really interesting to me. I mean, animation-wise, I think it could have been better, and maybe there was some material and texture stuff that could be, that looked like there was some sort of geometry issues in there, but it sold like sort of a more alien genre gun for me.
I quite liked it too. A lot of cool, interesting shapes throughout the gun, and the modeling seemed good, and the texturing, looked good. I didn't really like the little glowy bits all over it. It was a little bit too
random.
Yeah, random and like maybe misplaced. Maybe fewer of them, a lot fewer glowy, those little glowy squares. But overall, it was.
Yeah, we haven't really liked the glowy bits, have we?
I like glowy bits. I think it was one of the closer ones to implementing what the Jean style is with a human look.
That was cool, man. They actually took the concept, you know, and was like cutting out shapes on it. And, you know, that's what we would hope you would do, you know, because, I mean, that's why the concept is there for you to look at and absorb. Style cues and information from it.
Sean, let's hear your opinion.
The in-engine stuff was okay. I think the out-of-engine stuff looked a lot nicer, so I think they probably haven't worked with it before. So it just needs a little bit of tuning, I think it'll look fine.
One of the non-engine renders that looked really nice.
That looks really good.
That was the nicest of all of them.
You can achieve that in the engine, it's just...
Can you?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, I thought
you can.
Five minutes.
Well, that one's maybe a little longer for this one. But I was going to mention the alien stuff again. It's really cool when they start combining this outer cowling and then having the human interior. I think that's a really cool idea, and that's what they did here, and I think it really worked.
All right, guys, so seeing as this is a special entrant, I think we should just decide right here now if this team is going to go in.
Wow.
If this team does go in, then that would leave 4 places out of 8 for your other choices.
That's a lot of pressure.
Ready?
It is a lot
and
of pressure.
The other ones go into the wild card there, right?
Yes.
Instead of 3 into the wild card, it'll be 4 into the wild card.
There'll be 1 extra wild card. Okay. And if you don't vote them in, they're out of the competition completely.
Harsh.
That's a real do or die.
All right.
Right, are we ready?
All right.
Mark Skelton.
I'm going to say yes. I like this. I like these guys. And I think out of the group before, I think this gun is actually better than a couple of the ones previously. So.
All right, that's 1 yes. Sean.
I'm going to have to also say yes. The gun looked good in engine. It looked a little bit better outside, but I think the in-engine implementation can get even better.
All right. 2 votes. Chris Roberts, before you vote, if you do vote for this team to go through, then that basically means they're in, and sorry, Chris and Chris, you...
That's We're fine. Out?
You're back. Yeah.
You're out. Yeah. Off the couch.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, let's do it. Chris is together as one. Right?
Right.
What are we going to vote for then?
1, 2, 3. Yes!
Oh, my God!
Oh, man.
All right.
No, I think they should go. How dramatic. They had a great
We should have done that.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. Yes!
What the hell, man?
You guys aren't the Christmas.
Weird.
That's the problem.
It's like Laverne and Shirley up in here.
Yeah, it doesn't work as well.
So congratulations to 3 Dingo. All right. In the competition.
Nicely done.
Awesome. Good for them.
Brilliant.
And now there are only 4 that are going to go through. So email me your votes now. Come on, get your phones
out. Okay, here we go. Right.
All right, judges, the results are in. I can tell you 3 teams you voted out. Unanimously, Dragons of Nirvana, Persimmon Productions, and Archon all received 0 votes. However, you all joined the wildcard race. Now 3 teams you voted in unanimously. Shimapan.
Yep, good.
1-Bit Amoeba.
Mm-hmm.
And Shard Collective. Congratulations to all 3 of those teams. That leaves us with 2 teams, Infinite Shoe Monkey and 4 Horsemen. 1 received 3 votes, and the other received 2. Are you ready to reveal your vote live?
If we must.
Let's do it.
All right, Chris, you're up.
I voted for 4 Horsemen.
Chris Smith.
I voted for Infinite Shoe Monkey.
All right, 1 each. Chris Roberts.
I went for Infinite Shoe Monkey because I felt like they did more of everything than 4 Horsemen, who just did concept and a model, and that was it.
Okay, well, if you vote Infinite Shoe Monkey, then they're in. Is it you?
No. I voted for Horsemen, actually, despite myself and Chris's disagreement on it. I think we agree that it definitely needs to move forward.
All right, Mark, it all comes down to you. Who did you vote for?
Drum roll. 4 Horsemen.
All right, 4 Horsemen is in.
Well, there's no accounting for taste on this. Oh.
Infinite Shoe Monkey goes into the wild card race. The wild card race is officially open with 10 teams in it. So go vote now. Reveal the wildcard winner who goes in with the other 15 teams. All right, guys, get excited for next week for the competition? Yeah. That's when it really starts happening.
Gloves are coming off.
It's going to get ugly.
Yeah, I'm also really interested to see who the community picks.
It's going to be nice with when we get to the ships, because it's sort of, there's more to gain and more to lose. There's a lot to judge when you're going for the full ship.
There's going to be a lot more to talk about, I think, and there's a lot more.
Yep.
There's a lot more to think about for the teams as well as for the judges, so I think it'll be interesting.
All right, guys. Next week, 16 teams officially battle it out to win a grand prize of $30,000 and to be the winner of the Next Great Starship. See you next Friday.